living reckless, I've been breaking bad. I've been sleeping with men old enough to be my dad. And I know they probably hate it when I talk like this, but they all know I can't afford a therapist. So they'll humor me till they fall asleep. And I've been drinking heavy, which I can't afford. Bank account empty, don't wanna check my credit score. Chasing equity has only left me in debt more. I don't wanna be American anymore. Except for the alcohol, I'll drink it all. Inside and drink and eat until I pop, and send a risky text and see who's better's next.
Yeah. Facility.
not an omen, I don't know what is. Don't want anything from your dead hands, let alone a man that's shaking his. Never been the type to see the world in black and white, but evil does as evil is. If ignorance is absolute bliss, then what do you call this?
You attended Dr. King's I Have a Dream speech, but ended up against the Voting Rights Act. What changed? You would be paralyzed had it not been for publicly funded care from the Roosevelt Worms Freedom Institute, yet you've been anti-healthcare for decades? Pro-war for decades and served a grand total of 5 weeks in the military after using your connection to facilitate an honorable discharge due to inflammation of the optic nerve. Hypocrite.
You swear, pull through, for the many, not the few. You swear, pull through, for the many, not the few. You swear, pull through, for the many, not the few. For the many, not the few.
Star crossed.
but I need to get some considerable distance. Cause God, my God, I hate it here. Can't picture another geocentric year. Tartan feathered, I'll fly straight past the sun and disappear. I'll disappear. Don't wanna go to the barber shop anymore. I'll grow my hair to my knees and look even less manly. There's never really been a chair for me. I never played varsity. No man ever feared me. So I'll sit on the salad and wonder it's like to be the king. Don't wanna go to the barber shop anymore.
And the AC died days ago. Our fearless protagonist sits between Alfred, doodling yesterday's highlights on their tablet, and Logan, where present is succumbing to the warm air lulling him to sleep. With every passing second, Logan's head droops lower and lower, until finally it finds itself resting comfortably on our hero's shoulder. The following is an inner dialogue.
Thank you. Then he woke up.
We'll be right back.
trying to stay the night. And what are we doing? Where are we going? Tell me everything you like. What are we doing? Where are we going? You can decide.
About my mother's side, never got to feel my grandpa.
just bury you and pretend to keep on living. It's the big what if that I just couldn't handle. Today I'm marking your height on the wall. Tomorrow your picture on the mantle.
What if, what if, what if, what if I can't do this, I can't do this. What if, what if, what if, what if I can't do this, I can't do this. What if, what if,
God, the next person.
Never want to look out my window again, so I'll look for work as a projectionist for ruin. Bored, I'll go and log for a meager wage. Live at some dying cinema until my final days. Or maybe I should have become a colorist, picking the hues to make brown skin perfectly lit, making pretty pictures pop out of the page, spending all day sparking life into the heroes of a silver age. Or maybe a flower shop, how could I even resist? Create my own microcosm after hours in the garden. I wanna work with my hands, so maybe I'll learn a trade. Nothing flashy, just something to make sure all the bills are paid. Because America is a nation of middlemen, so I'll do whatever it takes to not be one of them, until some old white men decide my fate. They sign the dotted lines while black bodies fill in the blanks. This land was never meant for me. They told me racism ended back in the 70s, but the good old boys still have Senate seats, and the ones not cut for politics became police. And I think about converting a school bus constantly, just me and my tiny home exploring the world's topography. Only want for gas money, no more convenience fees, no living just to work and getting burnt out by 30. Americana stole my soul before it had me. If I was born anywhere else, would I still be me? I don't know what it is about this duplicitous country. I swear I hate it here, but for some odd reason I just can't seem to. Let me dream a utopia. When I was younger, I was gifted, I was gonna go far. But now I'm 30 and I'm bitter, reading the bell jar. Well, excuse me, Miss Plow, spare a second for me. How'd you write how I feel so vividly? Guess that's the funny thing about history. A person that never could have pictured me wrote down my thoughts so perfectly. On cold Massachusetts night in 63. Patience sure is.